Hey guys, you're welcome to my channel. I'm going to be telling you guys or sharing with you guys my struggles as a bisexual in Nigeria. I know some of you might not be really comfortable with this topic, but if you aren't, that's cool, you know, that's cool. If you're homophobic, that's cool. Leave the video now. Don't just drop unnecessary comments in the comment section.
Well, you know about like this. You know how fun to be like this.
My OG subscribers, what's good, what's popping? You guys really be pulling through. Hit me in the comment section, actually. Tell me what's popping with you. And if you're new here, you're just seeing my face. Hi, I'm Ijoma of Adora's World. I create lifestyle, beauty, fashion, content. If you want to laugh, all of that, hit the subscribe button. If you are a lesbian or a bisexual like me, I'm sure you have, just being a human being, self, there are struggles. So imagine being in one of the minority groups. You would have experienced like some hardships in this community. If you don't know what bisexual is, in simple terms, it's someone that is attracted, sexually attracted to both men and women. The first struggle I have in this community is, you all don't be taking us serious. Like, you literally think bisexuals are confused human beings. I don't get it. You see the bi there. Bi means two, meaning you can like both sexes. It's not like I really have to explain, but let me just really give you a brief breakdown of what being bisexual actually means. It means you're attracted to guys and you're attracted to girls. It's not like you're confused. There's no in-between. It's not like you're like, oh, you see girls or guys. It's like, I like the two. Okay? This doesn't mean like when I am in a relationship with a girl, I want a guy. Or when I'm in a relationship with a guy, I want a girl. No, it's just like two different things. You get two different scenarios. It's just like we can fall for either. So you guys need to stop saying we're not serious or we're just trying to have fun. No, we actually catch serious feelings. We actually love these people, and it's like, it's so annoying when people just try to make bisexuals seem like unserious. They also tag us as fools. Yeah, they also tag us as fools. And I'm like, okay, it's not bad to be a hoe, but you cannot attach our hoeing to being bisexual. Do you get it? Because even straight people are hoes. Even gay people are hoes. So like, what the hell?
I can't blame some of people that call you women a shew, but also a men say they are all a shew together. Everybody are a shew. When they are in their own, they are a shew. Me and my own, I'm a shew. Everybody on his own, a shew.
A lot of people do it. And it's not only in the I am straight community. It's also in the lesbian community. Like, okay, for one, my girlfriend felt like, when we started talking, she was like, oh, bisexual, she doesn't know how she feels about it. And it is because it has been so normalized when it comes from the same community as you, that is the LGBT community. It does cause some segregation. You get, it's like the studs, the like pure lesbians or femmes, or I don't know what the right thing to use, are regarded as the main lesbians. Do you get? Also, I just decide this means like, alright, I might date you if I feel like. I get there might have been some like issues that would have brought up all these trust issues in people about bisexual people cheating. Maybe there might have been some people that were bi curious and like, I just learned that word, bi curious and like, they like misled the other people to think, I don't know how to explain if you get me, but maybe there have been situations where people that claim to be bisexual or are bisexual have like cheated or done something that makes you feel like they are confused or they are hoes or all of that. Sorry about that, but you cannot blame that little like problem on all of us, okay?
Thank you.
So this is going to lead me to my next struggle. That is like, sort of everybody's trying to fuck. Yeah. Don't get me wrong. Don't get me wrong, guys. But like, you would literally see 10 men in your DM about, oh, let's have a threesome. When, like, bro, when I wasn't dating my girlfriend, you still look like scrap. Let's note that. If I had interest in you, I would be with you. Yeah, I would be with you. But I'm not with you because I am not attracted to you. Let's not get it twisted, okay? I'm not horny, okay? I'm satisfied. The next struggle I have is like, you know those derogatory all the side comments that are like reducing you. Do you get that? Is from threesome. Do you get different? That is from like my last thing that I just talked about. Someone literally asked me, lol, is it because I left my home that I am now dating lesbians? I felt the person's vibe like, oh, you're not dating lesbians because of daddy issue. I'm like, bro, I liked girls since way back then. Like, why are you trying to make it seem like there was a trauma that led to me being bisexual or me being lesbian? They make it seem like you turned a lesbian because guys didn't work for you. If that is it, that guys did not work for you and you figure out, oh, you like girls, cool, there's nothing wrong about it. But when someone just sits in their far away place and they're like, it's because of that you're a lesbian, it's because guys don't like you, it's because, oh, your daddy left you. Bro, no, I like that pussy. That's why. I like girls with a bit of like emotion. I like people that like to love me. Do you get? It's not about you. It's not about that. This will lead me to my next struggle. People expect you to explain your sexuality. I've gotten a lot of DMs. Like, it's cool if you're a lesbian, you're a bisexual, and you see my videos, you see my posts, and you're like, oh, I'm proud she's putting herself out there. I'd like to know how I can gain that type of confidence. But it's another thing when you come into my DMs like, oh, since when were you a lesbian? How did you become a lesbian? I didn't know you were a lesbian. You don't look like a lesbian. Bro, yes, I don't. Like, I did not write it on my forehead. How would I look like it? It's annoying. My sexuality is my sexuality. If I decide to fuck a horse today, you know what? There's nothing you can do about it. There's actually nothing you can do about it. So why not just mind your fucking business? You see, you go, you say, oh girl, I'm proud. You're putting yourself out there. Don't expect me to be explaining my sexuality to you. I don't know if you can tell, but it's another day, whole new day. I just put on these feet to make this video. The next struggle, I would say from the last point, is like people literally gossip and are mean to you just cause you're a lesbian, just cause you're bisexual. They feel like they should have like your business in their mouth, all of that stuff. Like, you literally know people are gossiping about you. I've not gotten the meanest comments, but I have gotten really mean comments. Not like I care, but yeah, people call me devil. Just stupid comments, like I said earlier. Next struggle, I'll say I experience a lot being bisexual. This might be also based on me and like my thought process. This struggle is losing friends and opportunities. Like, I feel like there is a high chance I might have lost some friends because well, they're not really my friends because I don't even know I lost them, do you get? But I know like people might have stopped like messing with me just because I came out as bisexual. And I'm like, you don't know shit because how am I really changed just because I came out? As for the opportunities, I feel like maybe brands. But the thing is that I wasn't getting brand deals before. So I cannot just blame it.
Excuse what I look like right now and any noise in the background. But honestly, I don't think I want to work with any brand that doesn't like completely accept me like as I am, like what I post and all of that.
Well, for some other people out there, there might be this thing, especially in Nigeria, of course, where everybody is homophobic or biphobic or anything freedom phobic actually.
I personally feel there are a lot of like LGBT people or people in the LGBT community that are like skilled and talented, and if the whole of Nigeria wants to miss out on that, their loss. That's why we are here. It's not cute.
People would just like want to be mean and not give you jobs, not give you certain things because they hate the fact that you are open about your sexuality. I know it's their personal problem. Self is not even my problem. If actually, like I was saying, it's my problem because it might just be me thinking that way. But if actually brands and friends do not want to be associated with me because I came out as a bisexual or because I have come out, then that's your problem. That's on you. That's your loss. You lost on this mega superstar. Okay, I made this video all about me. But yeah, this struggle, I'm sure like a lot of lesbians and gays, bisexuals, all of that go through it, especially for guys. Especially imagine if you're a femme guy, oh my god, people will literally look you down when you go to look for jobs. But we'll all be fine. I hate the staring, I hate the like harassment. God, I know like a lot of lesbians, bisexuals, gay people, like queer, transgender, just go through panic attacks in public because you're literally scared that someone is going to attack you because you're in the community. Do you get it? Doesn't happen for me as much, I'm not going to lie, because maybe people can't really tell. But for studs now, my girlfriend, there's that men are scared. These men, they don't like us, they don't like me because I say I love a woman. They hate it, they literally want to kill me. It's scary, and the harassment, the looking down on. Let me give you guys a little story time. You know, in my last like vlogs, when I was in Lagos, if you haven't watched it, watch it now. Watch it. When I was in Lagos,
I kept on using clips in this video, but I just wanted the end of the whole story time. In the hotel, we were waiting for Turkey downstairs, and then there was this man that was drunk and like couldn't pay for his bills opposite, but like I don't know when he came, but he came to our table and he was like opposite Ella, and he was then asking her if I was her sister, which is the normal thing, I guess, because people do not want to believe like we are together aside from us looking alike. But yeah, he was asking her, and we just looked at her like already irritated. But just like, I didn't answer her. She was like, no. And she just continued, like, did not mind him. So this man was standing here, and then he came to my face and he's like, oh, you're very fine. And I'm like he was literally here. And I'm like, why would you come to my face? He's like, if he does not tell me he's fine now, if he does not tell me I'm fine now, I'll be complaining. And he's drunk and everything. And I'm just here looking at, okay, this is a normal, like, problem for girls, women in Nigeria. But especially now that I'm with a girl, I'm like, what the fuck are you doing in front of me? I wish I slapped his face. I actually wish I did. The last problem I'll say is, like, a lot of people in the LGBT community are not able to come out about their sexuality, like, the last struggle about their sexuality because of shame, like, fear of rejection from family, friends. People go through, like, crazy stuff, suicide, depression, different things, just because they can't be themselves. I'm not saying every lesbian, gay person or bisexual, all of us, like, we don't have to say, oh, I am this or I am that. But when you fear saying, this is what I do, this is what I like, this is who I love, that is kind of scary and sad at the same time. Okay, so we've come to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it was, like, a bit educative and, like, as always, relatable. If you did read it, let me know in the comment section. If you have any other nice, cool comments, leave it in the comment section. Subscribe for more content. And I'll see you in my next video.